it's 9 o'clock. So half an hour is also there. So we will discuss articulators. Okay. Articulators, very small topic. Articulators and anterior tooth selection. That will cover it now. Now, what are articulators? Articulator, they are a mechanical instrument which represent temporomandibular joint, to which maxillary and mandibular cast can be attached so that we can simulate some or all of the movements. Okay. So it's a mechanical device to which maxillary and mandibular cast can be attached, which can simulate some of the movements or all the movements. Okay. That is articulator. Now, classification of articulator. This classification is very important. Arcon, non-arcon. You have to understand this, because many times this question has been asked. So in an arcon articulator, the condylar part or the condylar element, both are the same. Condylar element or the condylar path is present in the lower component. Okay. Lower component. Whereas the condylar path, condylar guidance, both are the same. Condylar path or the condylar guidance is present in the upper component. Okay. So it is exactly what is seen in our natural human being. Okay. The condyle is present, the condylar element is present in the lower component, whereas the condylar guidance or the condylar path is seen in the upper component. Okay. Non-arcon means exactly the opposite. The condylar element is seen in the upper component. Okay. The condylar element is seen in the upper component. Now tell me the common three-point articulator, the mean value articulator. Is it an arcon or a non-arcon? What we commonly use in our clinics, non-arcon. Okay. If the condylar rod or the condylar element is present in the upper component. Okay. Whereas the path is present in the lower component. So it's a non-arcon articulator. Now, based upon the theory of occlusion, three theories of occlusion are the Bonneville's theory of equilateral triangle. Based upon that, the Bonneville's theory, Wilson means Monson's theory, and spherical theory. All these, based upon these theories, conical theory, spherical theory, and equilateral triangle theory. Based upon these three theories of occlusion, articulators are classified into three. So according to Bonneville's equilateral triangle theory, distance between the two condyle and the midpoint of the lower incisor forms an equilateral triangle, and this length of this equilateral triangle is 4 inch. Okay. So 4 inch means how many millimeters? It is 110 millimeters. Now tell me which articulator you have seen with the same theory. Very common articulator what you use routinely, the mean value articulator. Mean value articulator is based upon Bonneville's equilateral triangle theory. So what will be the intercondylar distance of that your particular articulator, 4 inch. That means 110 millimeter. That has been asked as a question. Okay. 110 millimeter, okay, 110 millimeter or 4 inches. Okay. So that is equilateral triangle theory. Now coming to conical theory. According to conical theory was put forward by Hall. According to conical theory, the mandibular teeth moves over the upper teeth in such a way that it moves along the surface of a cone with central angle 45 degree. Okay. So he suggested that the mandible moves over the maxillary teeth in such a way that the mandible moves over the surface of a cone with apex angle 45 degree. Clear. So that is conical theory. So based upon that, an articulator was fabricated. That is Hall's automatic articulator. Okay. So conical theory of occlusion. Coming to spherical theory by Monson. Spherical theory of Monson, same way, instead of cone, here it was a spear with the center at glabella. So the lower teeth moves over the upper teeth in such a way that It moves over the surface of a sphere with a diameter. Diameter. Remember, diameter 8 inches. And center of the sphere will be at the glabella. Okay. So that are the three classifications for articulator based upon the theories of occlusion. Okay. So two classification we have studied. Archon, non-archon, and based upon the theories of occlusion. Okay. So spherical theory was put forward by Monson. Conical theory was put forward by Hall. And equilateral triangle theory was put forward by Bonville. Okay. Now, this classification is the important one. This classification is important one. It has been put forward by an international workshop at University of Michigan in 1972. So they classified it into four groups: class 1, class 2, class 3, and class 4. Okay. Class 1, class 2, class 3, and class 4. So the class 1. There are subclasses are there. Subclasses are there. Don't worry about the subclasses. Usually subclasses are not asked for you people. It's a postgraduate level classification. Go for the class 1, class 2, class 3, class 4 classifications. Okay. Class 1, it is a simple device where only one motion is possible. Only vertical motion is possible. Up, down, up, down. So your hinge articulator. Hinge articulator is a perfect example for your class 1 articulators. Okay. Hinge articulators are the common example or the very perfect example for the class 1 articulator. So it's a simple holding device which accept only one vertical motion. Okay. So that is class 1. Class 2. Class 2 is horizontal and vertical motion are possible, not able to accept a phaseboard transfer. Okay. So vertical motion possible, slight horizontal motion possible, but phaseboard transfer is not possible because it cannot accept the phaseboard. Okay. Perfect example, mean value articulator. Okay. So it is the mean value articulator. Okay. So class 2, it is horizontal vertical motion possible. It can accept phaseboard transfer. Clear? Now, class 3. Horizontal vertical motion possible and accept phaseboard with limited facility. Okay. So with a limitation, with some limitations, it will accept phaseboard transfer. Okay. That is class 3. Class 3. Subclassifications are there. Don't worry about subclassifications now. Just understand class 1, class 2, class 3. Okay. So horizontal, vertical motions are possible. Phaseboard transfers acts. Class 3. Okay. Accept phaseboard transfer with limitation. Most of your semi-adjustable, not most of the, all the semi-adjustable articulators, all the semi-adjustable articulators what we use in our clinics are coming under this particular group, class 3. Hanno articulator, Dinar articulator, Whipmix articulator, all the articulators come under this group. Okay. So subclasses are there. Don't worry about subclasses now. Okay. Now class 4. Three-dimensional registration and orientation of the mandible along with the phaseboard transfer. So three-dimensional articulators are the articulators, only articulators which can accept kinematic phaseboard. Okay. So when we need a, means when we want a kinematic phaseboard transfer, we require 3D articulators, class 4 type of articulators. Okay. Otherwise, it is not possible to transfer the exact hinge axis because here you can change the intercondylar distance. You can, all the rotations are possible, all the mandibular movements are possible. It is completely three-dimensional representation of your mandible and maxilla, both. Okay. So it is the three-dimensional representation of the three-dimensional representations of your mandibular movements. Okay. So pantographic tracing procedure, pantograph is an example for three-dimensional articulator. Pantograph, okay. So this is the kinematic phaseboard, and this kinematic phaseboard requires a class 4 type of articulators. So to accept the kinematic phaseboard is this thing. It is a cumbersome device. It's not easy to use. Even the highest grade of prostaglandins don't use kinematic phase flow because it's very difficult. Okay. Now basic classification. Semi-adjustable articulator, non-adjustable articulator, semi-adjustable articulators. So again, semi-adjustable articulators, I have told you, it comes under class 3. Again, in semi-adjustable articulators, both arcbone and non-arcbone are possible. Arcbone, I have told you, the condylar element is present in the lower part, whereas the upper part contains the condylar path. Okay. So non-arcbone articulators, these are the dentators and Hanno H2. Both are semi-adjustable articulators, class 3 articulators, and they come under non-arcbone articulators. Okay. Usually they don't ask examples of non-arcbone articulators, but if at all if they are asking it, just remember the names. Okay. Dentators, Geissy, Hanno H series. Okay. Hanno H series are non-arcbone articulators. Okay. This again, dentatus articulator, just a picture.